to this week's vlog. This is my first day without Will, because if you watched my last vlog, Will has been sold. So it's just Finny. And today we are off to a working hunter show at Anvil Park, which I'm really looking forward to. I just haven't spent like much one-to-one time with Finley as I would have liked to. He always, because he's sort of been there, done it, he's older, he always gets put back a little bit. But today I'm really looking forward to. We're doing the 80 centimeter class and the 90 centimeter class, aren't we? He has not competed in any shows since Equifest. So yeah, and he hasn't really done much jumping. I've just been hacking him, and we've been actually working on his fitness a little bit and doing lots of canter work out in the fields and on the stubble fields. And I'm really lucky here, I'm on a big farm, so there's loads of lovely, lovely fields to ride on. And I think his favourite thing to do is just to go cantering out on the fields, isn't it? So I'm really looking forward to today, just having some me and Finley time. It'll either go well or it won't. Finley's a really funny horse to jump. Anything on grass, he's fantastic. He's so much more up for it. On a surface, he can back off a bit more. So I generally usually try and avoid jumping him on a surface because I find him much harder work. But saying that, sometimes he's okay. So, and he's not jumped for a while, so I'm hoping he's going to be excited. And yeah, I'm really happy and buzzing for today. Finley's just playing with his ball. So I've just got to the yard and it's very quiet with just him here. And there's one other livery here who is retired. So it's very, very quiet. I'm going to give him a nice bath with my hot horse shower. And then I'm going to plait him, and I'm going to take my time and trim him up, make him look beautiful. And our class is well after 1 o'clock. So we're going to aim to get to the venue at 1 o'clock. And I think it's the fourth class in, so it probably won't start till 2, but I'd rather get there and warm him up and have lots of time than be rushing. I'm not sure how many entries there are in the classes. And the judge today is Viv Bruce, who actually judged him on the second day of Equifest. And yeah, she's a fantastic working hunter judge. I really like her. So I'm looking forward to today. And there's quite a lot of showing friends going, like, people are actually travelling because nowhere really holds working hunt around here. So should see a few friends, which should be nice too. Anyway, I'm rambling, so I'm going to get on with bathing my mucky grey pony. Nice. Are you hoping for some breakfast because I'm hanging around? Yes? Okie dokie. You going to help bath? No? Alrighty then. Oliver, you're hoping for a treat stick? You are, look, dreamies. You're on the table, cat. This week it's turned really cold here. It's been like 9 degrees at night. I think it's only about 11 degrees this morning. And I don't know if you can see how like woolly his coat is getting now. And he's got so much dust in his coat because it's a bit thicker. But he's looking really well, aren't you? But hopefully after a good bath, you'll soon scrub up nicely. Yeah, he has just had his bath. I didn't video his bath because it's quite hard for me to like film and bath. And you've seen me bath him anyway. And he's now just sort of drying out, aren't you? And that will probably be the last proper bath he has before winter. So that's done. I'm just going to give him a minute to dry off. It's going to take a little bit longer to dry off because he's got such a thick winter coat coming through. So I'm going to give him a minute to dry off. Just go and do the poo picking, and then I'm gonna start plaiting, and I'm just gonna band. It's working hunter. I'm not too worried about stitching. Just gonna chuck some bands in and make him look presentable.
I'm trying a new product whilst plaiting. I'm trying the Smart Grooming Plaiting Wax, which is kind of like a lip salve where you just push it out the bottom and put it on the top, and that's to get all those straggly hairs in. And we'll see how we get on with it. And I'm just gonna use plaiting bands and this. And yeah, we'll see how they turn out.
Finley's now all plaited and cleanish. I'm just gonna put his travel boots on. Plaits are okay, they're a little bit, some are up and some are down. I like these two. I don't like that one very much. I don't like that one very much. But I'd usually put like a slink on so they're all laying nicely, but I'm not too worried because we're only going down the road. It's just working hunter, and with working hunter, a clear round is a clear round. So even if you are filthy and in all the wrong stuff,
a clear round will always beat a full fault, unless it's judged on performance or judged in a different way. But Finley's first class is a performance class, so I'm not quite sure how that's going to be judged. It just says performance class 80 centimetres. And then his next one is the small open. If I'm feeling super, super ballsy today, I might even jump him in the open at the end, which is a metre, but I haven't jumped him that big for quite a long time. I used to, when Finley was young, like when he was like 8 or 9, we used to jump in some Hoyt qualifiers and he used to jump the metre classes, but because he is 14, he's kind of winding down. You having a little nap, Finney? But I'm just going to put him back in, put his travel boots on and his tail guard, let him go in the stable and have a wee, and then we will get on our way. He looks really full of it, don't you?
I've arrived at Anvil Park Stud in Norfolk. It's only about 40 minutes, well, half an hour ago, according to Google, but more like 40 minutes of my slow driving. It's very quiet here today. The last time I came here, I went on my own with Finley, and I did film it, and it was packed. I couldn't even find a space in the car park. But there's probably about 8 lorries here today, so pretty quiet. But I know for a lot of people, kind of the season has ended, and when the horses start to get woolly, they just have a bit of a break. But yeah, I'm going to go check out the Working Hunter course. They're currently on a lunch break. And I think they've got a 60 class, 70 class, and then I'm in the 80, something like that. So I've got a little minute, and Finley will just wait here for a moment whilst we go have a look. Watching the course and watching a few riders go around, I hopped on Finley and just started walking him round. He is 14, so I like to give him a really good walk round, really soften and loosen up his joints, let him have a stretch. So I did do like walk, trot, canter, popped him over the jump a few times, and then I like to just keep walking him round, keeping him moving so he doesn't get stiff. And I found this lovely pony that looked identical to Finley. So we were just walking around and having a chat, which, I mean, I love just chatting to people at shows and sort of making new friends. So here I am, just kind of waiting for my class. And the first class we entered was the 80 centimeters performance class. And he felt really ready, so I was just walking around, chilling, ready for our class to start. Here we are in the ring, approaching fence one, and I just wanted to focus on having this forward-going, bouncy canter that was positive. I don't want him backing up towards the fences, which is something Finley likes to do. As soon as he sees something scary, he kind of backs off, like here. And I just have to be quicker with my leg. Sharp turn to four. You can see he's just lost his rhythm a little bit through there. I gave him a pat to kind of say, well done for saving us, because I just kind of, I'm not quick enough to be on it when he backs off. So I made sure I used the corner to ride him forward here. I was like, get on. It makes it really hard for me to ride him when he does this. As you can see here, I'm kicking and sort of, you really have to ride him. He's fine once he's jumped all the fences, but he's always like this for his first round, just really sticky. And if you kind of just sit there, he will just stop. But this is better over this fence. Here he is going into eight, and he's, I mean, it's not even scary. He's not scared of it. he's just backing off and testing that I am there and I am going to sort of make him do it. This is just a Finley thing that he's always done. He absolutely loves jumping and loves his job. He just likes to test my riding ability. But so far, we're jumping clear. It just wasn't the most fluent round, but I am happy with his rhythm between the fences, and I am using my space and kind of thinking about my course more. This one had a water tray underneath, and I knew he'd back off. So you can see me just sort of show him the whip over that one, and I gave him a pat for being such a good boy over it. It was a shame it didn't like flow more, but overall I was really pleased to jump clear and that I actually got him going in a nice forward rhythmical canter. So here we are in the next class, which was the open 90 centimetre class. So as this was an open class, she did want to know his age and she wanted to look at his confirmation, and she did let me know I would be doing a show afterwards. And some of the jumps looked quite beefy, especially some of the spreads. So I thought this time, really get after him, get him going forwards and do not let him back off, get that rhythm. So I sort of really pushed him into this first fence, which was a mistake because we had it down. I should have not pushed him that much. And even though he is thinking of sort of backing off a little bit, he's much better when he's in this super forward rhythm. And as you can see here, I'm actually quicker to sort of get onto him. Sharp turn over four, which I was really pleased with. I was just a bit unbalanced. I need to be looking up more as I kind of go over the fence and I focus so much on jumping the fence, I forget about afterwards. This jump was huge, and I was really pleased with how he handled that. And this is the one he doesn't like, so he's got water trays underneath, scraping over that, which I give him a big pat for, but he just lost his rhythm, backed off, and I wasn't quick enough to sort of get him over it. So we're now approaching seven, which was a skinny, jumped that really nicely, changed his leg for me, and over eight, which much better. We're flowing so much more, and me just giving him lots of encouragement and telling him when he has been a good boy. Over nine, which was another big spread, jumping it huge, I was happy with that. And just one more to go, which was the one with the water tray underneath, which of course he's scared of water trays. He's not, he's just Finley, he's a liar. But I thought, go on, get over it. And he was fine over this one. So overall, much better round that course. Has just jumped the 90 centimeter class. He just had the first one down. I just sort of rushed him into it too much, But I was really pleased because there's some really big fences out on the 90 course and I haven't jumped him in 90 in ages. So I was really, really pleased actually. And he's never jumped here before. So yeah, it was really, really good. And I'm just waiting for my placing now. There's been some really lovely ponies here and quite a few clears, but I've just really enjoyed riding Finley as always. Hey Finley. He's just the superstar as always.
Bandaged up, ready to go, and I've got him his favourite stud muffin. You've been a superstar, Finny. Good boy. Taking your plaits out, and this is what Will did to him, look. Yes. You've been such a good boy today. Time to go home. Enjoyed your jumping. Good
boy. So really, really pleased with today. There was quite a lot of competition. Look at his hair. he jumped clear in the 80 style and came fifth. So really pleased. He jumped a lovely clear round and I think there was seven in it. And then we jumped the 90 and I decided to be much more forward and more confident and sort of get things flowing a bit more. And he came third. We just had the first fence down. I definitely hurried him into it a little bit. Yes. Mwah. But it's been lovely to spend the day with this one. And just lovely to be jumping him again. It's my first 90 in ages. I haven't sort of jumped him that big in a while. And it's just lovely to have some me and Finny time. Isn't he lovely? He's the loveliest horse, aren't you? So we're going to go home now. And I will see you all next week. Bye. Say bye, Finny.